Everybody. Like, I know you. That's why I was able to recognize you.
Okay. I made myself famous.
Yeah, you have.
Thank you.
Committee investigation.
I'm not sure how much it proved. It was kind of a do-nothing exercise. $7 million worth of do-nothing exercise. $7 million worth of do-nothing exercise. We're here to say to all of you who believe in justice that we want new trials for the torture victims. You know who the torture victims are. John Burge is free in Florida, living like a king. These men are still behind bars and not had justice. They have not been fair trials. There's hesitation to ask to apologize. An apology is not good enough. An apology is not strategy.
Free!
An apology is not strategy. We want no trial. We want justice. The people pretending to be a daily. The letter from that handsome young man in the corner on the left there. Stanley Howard, whose father is here. Come, Travis. Come let the people see who you are. His son has written the letter to Mayor Daley, and we will be delivering that letter at the end of this program. Let's move on with our speakers. We're first going to hear from a dear friend of Stanley Howard, Michelle, who is going to read to you the letter that Stanley Howard gave to her to read to this body. He would be here himself if he were free, as he ought to be, but in his absence, she will be reading the letter.
I guess we have to come in, Andrew.
All right. My name is Michelle Martin. And his letter states his time. 5 years ago, Special Prosecutor Edward Egan was appointed to ascertain what exactly occurred in Area 2 and Area 3 Police Headquarters under the command of John Burke. 4 years and $7 million later, Egan issued a well-watered-down report aimed exclusively at burning the Burge torture victims and the four death row prisoners part back up the Rhine.
Oh, okay, good.
Still, in the face of overwhelming evidence, inmate in Illinois. Let's give Darby a hand.